Okay, now we are going to solve practice problem 7.1 from Sadiku book. And here is the question. I will read them for you. Refer to the circuit in the figure 7.7. So I have redrawn the figure here. And that VC0 is equal to 60 volt. So we have VC here and VC0. VC0 is equal to 60 volt. This is our initial condition for this capacitor. Okay, and then determine VC, VS, and I0, IO, for T greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so we have this circuit here, and we can take a look at it first. So let's see this resistance here. We have 12 ohm and 6 ohm. Both of them is in parallel. So I can redraw them into one resistor. Okay, let's redraw the circuit to simplify it. So I will have the resistance value of 12 parallel with 6, and that will be 12 multiplied by 6 divided by 12 plus 6, which is 12 multiplied by 6 divided by 18. And we can cancel this into 3, and we can cancel this into 4. So we will have 4 ohm. And so we can redraw the circuit into this circuit here. So we will have 12 and parallel with 6 becomes 4 ohm here. And let's mark the voltage. This voltage is still the same as Vs because the voltage here and here is the same as a parallel circuit, so we will have Vs here, and the current that passed through this 8 ohm resistor is still I0, and the current, not the current, the voltage across this capacitor is still Vc. So we have a simplified circuit here, and then we can simplify this further into a single resistor and a single capacitor. Okay, so this is 4 ohm in series with 8 ohm. So let's redraw the circuit again. So we will have 4 ohm plus 8, which is 12 ohm resistor. Okay, let's redraw the circuit. Okay, so 4 ohm and 8 ohm becomes 12 ohm, and let's put the label here. So the current that pass through this resistor here is the same as this one, right? I0. So I will have IO or I0, whatever you call it. And then this one is still VC. But the voltage across this 12 ohm is not VS. That is the different voltage. So this one is VC. Okay, so now we have an RC circuit. And remember that we have the initial condition of VC0 is equal to 60 volt. This will be useful later. Okay, so now let's do analysis on this RC circuit. Okay, we will do nodal analysis in this circuit. So I will choose this one as our ground. So in this reference voltage will be 0. And I will use this node here, node A, as our KCL node. So we will need to use KCL at node A. Okay, and KCL said that the sum of the current that goes in is equal to the sum of the current that goes out. Okay, I have this one. So here the current that goes in into node A is this I0 from resistor, and that I0 is actually 0 minus VA, 0 minus VA divided by the resistance value, which is 12. And then this current will also going there, because this is a series circuit, this is also I0. So I0 is going here and then there. And remember that the current that passes through a capacitor is a CdV dt. So the C value is 1 over 3. And then D over dt of the voltage here, which is Va, minus the voltage here, which is 0. Minus 0. Okay, so we will have these equations now. And then let's simplify this. And Va here is this voltage with respect to ground, and it is the same as Vc. So 0 minus Va is equal to minus Vc. And then divide it by 12. And this one is 1 over 3. Va minus 0 is equal to Vc. So I will have dVc over dt. Okay, let's rearrange this equation. So I will have dVc over dt is equal to minus 3 multiplied by Vc divided by 12. And this will cancel into 4. So I will have dVc over dt is equal to minus 1 over 4 of Vc. Okay, so we have this first order differential equations. We need to solve this. Okay, our whiteboard is nearly full. Let's erase this. Okay, so now we have differential equations with first order. So we need to solve this one. So I will use the separation of variables. So I will isolate the all that contains Vc to the left hand side and all that contains dt to the right hand side. So I will have to move this one to the left hand side. So I will have dVc over Vc. And then this one will be minus 1 over 4 dt. Okay, now we can integrate both sides. So I will have this one integrated. And this one, because this is a constant, we can just put the integral sign here. Okay, so I will have dVc over Vc integrated. That will be natural log of Vc, right? And then this one will be minus 1 over 4 t plus some constant. Let's just name constant 1. And then we will have Vc is equal to e to the, okay, let's rewrite this to minus 0.25 t plus C1. Okay, now Vc is equal to this one. I want to rewrite this as e to the minus 0.25 t e to the C1. And remember, e to the C1 is also a constant. So let's name that constant, what is it? C2 maybe. So I will rename this as C2 e to the minus 0.25 t. Okay, so this is a function of time, so I can rewrite this as Vc with a function with respect to time. So I will have this one, and now we need to find out what is the value of C2. So we need to do this, and how? We have this initial condition. So Vc at 0 will be 60 volt. So let's write this here. When Vc 0, it is equal to 60 volt. Okay, and Vc 0 meaning that when we plug this 0 into this function, so I will have C2 e to the minus 0.25 multiplied by 0, and that will equal to 60. And this one, e to the minus 0.25 multiplied by 0, which becomes e to the 0, and e to the 0 is equal to 1. So I will have C2 multiplied by 1 is equal to 60. So I will get C2 is equal to 60. And so our VC will be 60 e to the minus 0.25 t, and our unit is volt. So this is our VC. So we have found first variable that we are asked in the problem. So this one. Okay, so we still need to find VS and IO. Let's put this here and I will clean the board. Okay, now I have cleaned the board and I redraw this circuit as this one, the first simplification of the circuit here. So 12 parallel with 6 becomes 4. And I have put the label here. So this is VS here. So this is VS because the voltage will be the same as this is parallel. So this is VS and this still be IO and this still be VC. Okay, to find VS. We can just use voltage divider. So I will have 4 divided by 4 plus 8 multiplied by the voltage here between here and the ground here. So this is our ground, and that voltage is equal to VC. So VC, so we'll have VS is equal to this one, and so we will have VS is equal to 4 divided by 12, that is 1/3, right? 1/3 multiplied by VC. So if VC is changing with respect to time, VS is also changing with respect to time. So I will have VS of time is equal to 1/3 multiplied by this value, VC over time, 60 e to the minus 0.25 t, and we will have VS t is equal to 20 e to the minus 0.25. So this is the value of VS, which is the second variable that asked in the problem. Okay, we still have one more variable to solve. Okay, I will put this here and we will solve for I0. Okay, the next variable we need to solve is I0 here, I0. So to find I0, we will need to use Ohm's law. So I0 is going here, but because this is a series circuit, it is also past this 4 ohm resistance. So if we take a look at this 4 ohm resistance, the voltage here will be 0 because this is the ground, and the voltage at this node is equal to VS. So I can find IO by using Ohm's law, which is 0 minus VS divided by the resistance value, which is 4. So we'll have minus VS divided by 4. And so I will have IO over time is VST. VST is this one. So we'll have 20 e to the minus 0.25 t divided by 4. So I will have IOT is equal to 5e to the minus 0.25 t, and the unit is ampere. Okay, so we have found all the variables that asked in the problem, Vc, Vs, and Io. Hopefully, I did not make any mistakes in my calculations. Let me know if I did. And do not forget to like and subscribe to my channel if you find this helpful. Also, share it to your friends via social media. Thank you. Bye-bye.